Now, Nelson Mandela further says that I knew the oppressor must be liberated just as surely as the oppressed. Now, who is the oppressor? Oppressor is one who puts the restrictions. Jo dusro pe restrictions dalta hai. And who is oppressed? Oppressed is one jis pe restrictions dala jata hai. So, one who is facing the restrictions is the oppressed, and the one who is doing the restrictions, he is the oppressor. Now, he says that oppressor must be liberated and as surely as the oppressed. So, oppressor must be liberated from what? From what? He says that both are, the oppressor as well as the oppressed, both are in chains. So, they should be liberated from what? Oppressed is obviously put in chains by the oppressor. But then what is the oppressor in bondage of? A man who takes away another man's freedom is a prisoner of hatred. So this is what he is bondage of. He is put in chains of what? Of hatredness. A man who is oppressor, he is a prisoner of hatredness. Okay, he has so much of hatredness in himself that he cannot see anything else. He only knows one thing, is to do atrocities and cruelty and put restrictions on the oppressed. He is locked behind the bars of prejudice and narrow-mindedness. And such a man, that is an oppressor, who is inside the prisoner, who is a prisoner of hatredness, is behind, locked behind the bars of prejudice. What is prejudice? Prejudice means a strong dislike without any reason. So, without any reason, you don't like somebody. A strong dislike without having an appropriate reason. So, a man who is a prisoner of hatred, he is a narrow-minded person, and he is behind the bars of prejudice. So, he is equally in chains. But he is in chains of what? He is in chains of hatredness, of narrow-mindedness and prejudices. Okay? I am not truly free if I am taking away someone else's freedom. So, now he says that if I am taking away somebody's freedom, then how can I be free? Because I am bonded in the prison of hatredness, and that is why I am taking away somebody else's freedom. Just as sure I am not free when my freedom is taken from me. So, he say these are the value-based questions. These are very important lines, and this teaches us a lot of things. So, these lines of Nelson Mandela gives a moral teaching to us. Okay? A philosophical teaching, a moral teaching, and these lines are very important from examination point of view. Now, that is why I said this chapter is very important, because questions can be framed from any line of this chapter. These are value-based lines, value-based questions can be put from here. The oppressed and the oppressor alike are robbed of their humanity. So, if the oppressed and the feels that he is more strong and he has got the freedom, and so he can put restrictions on the oppressor. So, if the oppressor feels that he is free and he is more powerful and he can put the restrictions on the oppressed, then let me let you know that both are robbed of humanity. What is robbed? Robbed means jinse chori kar liya gaya hai. Kya chori kar liya gaya hai? Humanity. Jinke andar human feelings nahi rahe gaye hain. Dono ke paas human feelings nahi rahe gaye hain. Why? Because ek जो दूसरों पे अत्याचार कर रहा है उसके पास से ह्यूमैनिटी पहले ही चोरी हो चुकी है, इसीलिए वो दूसरों पे अत्याचार कर रहा है. सो समवन हु एन ऑप्रेसर हु इज पुटिंग रेस्ट्रिक्शंस, हु इज डूइंग क्रुएल्टी ऑन द अदर पर्सन, दैट मीन्स द ऑप्रेस्ड, ही इज अ प्रिजनर ऑफ हेट्रेड, ही हैज अ नैरो माइंडेडनेस एंड ही इज बिहाइंड द बार्स ऑफ प्रेजुडिस. ही इज हैविंग अ थॉट फॉर विच ही हैज नो पर्टिकुलर रीजन, अ रीजनेबल रीजन वाई ही इज हैविंग सच अ थॉट, वाई डज ही डिसलाइक द ब्लैक पीपल. ओके, and so he is robbed of humanity, and the oppressed people, the one who is facing all sort of restrictions, the one who is facing all sort of atrocities and cruelties, that person is obviously he is not behaved he in a human way by the oppressor. So he has already been robbed by the oppressor, and both of them are robbed of their humanity. So I hope you have understood this, and this finishes off the chapter. So now students, I'm again and again telling you, please give a good reading of this chapter. You need to know each and every line, because especially reference to context can be taken from any of the lines of this chapter. Now this chapter has a lot of moral teachings, so you can get a number of value based questions from this chapter, and we'll try cover up all the questions that probable questions which can come up. So do a proper reading, and in case you have any problem, get back to me. So students, we see how Nelson Mandela, he calls the oppressor and the oppressed both to be prisoners, and he says that both needs to be liberated, the oppressor and the oppressed. So this chapter gives us a lot of moral values, and if we can imbibe these moral values in our lives, we will surely be good human beings. So I hope this chapter can put a little bit of reflection in each and everybody's life, and we will strive to become good human beings and serve humanity to our fullest.